if you were like, hey, I've got like a diamond coated emu, like it's in North Korea. You could invade it and take it for yourself. Like, do I want a diamond coated emu? No. But on the other hand, why the fuck not?
You know, I wouldn't be surprised. Well, I would be surprised. But, like, it would be awful yet funny if on Putin's deathbed, if he was still in charge, if he decided to finish the war with Japan.
He's like, hey, guess what? That ceasefire we had. World War II's not over till I say it's over, bitch. It's mine. I demand the unconditional surrender of the Empire of Japan. But we are not an empire anymore. That does not matter to me. You know why that doesn't matter to me? Because I don't give a shit. Give Hokkaido to Russia. Or else. Why do you want Hokkaido? I don't know. I don't want Crimea. Who fuck knows? Doesn't fucking matter. Give it to me. I felt like it.
Rightfully part of Russia. Yeah. It's full of my Russian people right here. Yeah. All of them with their slanty eyes and their technology. It gets cold like Russia sometimes, right?
I wanted some fresh, like, sea crabs, and instead of just buying them from Alaska because they're boycotting me because I invaded Ukraine, I now need to get them from Hokkaido. So that's right. That's what happens when you boycott Russia. I invade you and take your shit anyway.
Oh, Russia. I don't like Russia. As we've already stated, I am a Soviet Union supporter. Because at least the Soviet Union knew.
At least they had, like, plans and...
They had a plan, they had an ideology, and they knew how to execute the ideology with the plan. Like, what we're going to do is we're going to raise a massive army. But we don't have guns! Don't worry about that. This is the Soviet Union. What?
We're going to take all of our food and sell all of it. I mean all of it. And we're going to buy some machines. And we're going to build factories. Don't we need that food to eat? Shut up. I'm not done yet. And then, once half the people of Ukraine have starved to death, then we'll have some guns. Haven't you ever heard? I read this in a fucking college textbook. Guns or butter.
What?
That's not a continuum. That's an either or as far as the Soviet Union is concerned. Guns or butter. No compromise, bitch. This is the Soviet Union. Continuums and compromise? Do you think Stalin runs that way? Fuck no. We sell all of the food and buy all of the guns. But now we have all these guns and no means to, like, transport them to the people so that they can shoot them. That doesn't matter. I don't care. I'm going to start a war with Germany or Poland or just fucking anyone. It doesn't matter. It's all shit that's over there. And we're going to have huge, the most massive military buildup anyone's ever seen. And no way to get it to the front. None. Like at the start of his invasion of Finland, 34,000 tanks. And he couldn't, they couldn't, they were stuck in factories. They're like, what do we got all these tanks. He's like, well, can't you just drive them over there? They're like, no, takes a lot of fuel to. We need, like, a train or something. It's like, a train? What do I look like? Fucking Germany?
Hey,
they had to build special train tracks just to, like, drive the tanks. Because they were like, oh, we need distribution and shit. Anyway.
Some people don't think of the logistics.
Are you still signaling?
What?
He's in the game. You're in the game.
What? I'm in the game.
No, you're not.
What?
You're in the wrong game.
What?
How can you be in the game when we're in the game and you're not here?
Yeah, it says open.
What?
And there's no ready check mark.
Did you load the mod?
You're right. It says open.
Did you?
Because Corey's not here.
Did you load the mod? You see the
match in
the background?
It says next war.
Did Jason load the mod?
I'll rejoin. Doesn't
make any sense because I'm in here.
But... I'll rejoin the game. Wow, here I was waiting for you.
Yeah, I've been in here since the start of the EA conversation.
Like, they probably get together with their fucking CEO buddies and they're like, let me explain to you how capitalism works. These people buy any shit I fart out. Watch this, I'll just make a game that's straight up not a game. You mean like Depression Quest? No. Not gonna go all fucking Zoe Quinn on you. Let's just make it, let's call it Sim Village.
Well, then.
And, like, no one will fucking work.
Didn't they, what was it? Didn't they publish Warhammer? And I know, or not Warhammer, Warhammer Online, I guess is what it would be called.
They did.
And I never played Warhammer that you could invade the Three Kingdoms, and you were supposed to have these giant PvP battles in, like, to capture the cities or whatever. Except for when they released it, there was only one. So, they're like, one of the most major PvP elements of the game was unusable because there was...
Here's what happened with Warhammer. The studio that produced it said, the game's not ready. And EA said, huh, well, you need to release it this quarter or we're going to drop you. So they released it like a year or two early and it fell apart within a year.
That's...
Yeah.
Like the city stuff, you're right, it didn't work. Though if there were three factions, that would have been shit. It would have turned into, like, Secret World or Guild Wars? Three-way PvP?
Oh, yeah, because it was just two-way. It was just evil versus good, right? What the hell would three-way have been? Man, that would have been...
The fuck knows.
Man. Yeah.
I really hate three-way.
Yeah.
It's true. I don't know why people think that works either, because there's no motivation. Unless you physically force people to properly three-way... There's no, like, it doesn't work how you put it down on paper.
Oh, yeah.
The two weaker civilizations will attack the stronger. Stronger of the two weaker civilizations will attack the weaker.
That actually worked, though, in a sense, for Guild Wars, at least in the last competitive season.
Well, only amongst people who can think.
Out of mutual hatred, but also the kind of organization it takes to do that. To put two servers together. But they 2v1'd us for 9 weeks. As in, like, standing next to each other and not attacking.
That takes vendetta and planning.
It does.
It's not to tab target. It's so, like, some asshole would do it. Like...
There'd be, like, 80 people on the right side inside the keep, and there'd be 80 people on the left side. And one of them would cover the waypoint, so when we put waypointed in, we'd get slaughtered, and the other half would take it. Then they'd divvy it up, and they'd be like, well, we'll win this week, and you win next week, and we'll win the week after, and then we'll fight the last week.
That's crazy.
That's
great. So, like, even when it works the way it's supposed to, it sounds incredibly gay.
Yeah.
You're like...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Their server pretty much imploded because people were like, you know, some people were like, wow, this is boring as fuck. We hate you guys. So they left. And then.
Yeah. Like, sure. Even when it works perfectly, just. What was I going to. I wonder where they are going with that. Are they going to my capital? Are they going to Angkor Wat?
Yeah. You know, it's not a good thing. There to be stacks in the interior. They should all be going to Corey or someone.
Sorry.
You are outfitted to deal with it with your protective.
Yeah.